Hello students, today we will be dealing with the chapter of human anatomy, that is the human eye. So let's start. Before proceeding in the chapter, we will be getting a brief overview on this diagram and then I will be connecting the terms with the other respective slides. Okay, principally human eye is divided into three regions, that is the outer region, the middle region and the inner region, or we can say it as the outer layer, the middle layer and the inner layer. Okay, the outer layer is called as the sclerotic layer. This term sclerotic layer is derived from the word scleros. Okay, what does this word scleros mean? It means tough, hard, fibrous tissue. You might have studied in your junior classes regarding sclerenchyma. Okay, what does that, what was it? Sclerenchyma is the simple permanent dead tissue in plants. This scleros word means tough, fibrous and hard tissue. Okay, this sclerotic layer is hard, tough and it is a fibrous tissue. So let's write down it here. This outer layer which is represented by the yellow color, this is the sclerotic layer. This sclerotic word is derived from the word scleros, which means tough, hard, fibrous tissue. Okay. Another thing, the sclerotic layer looks like a white opaque substance layer. We can say, what do we mean by opaque? See, in physics, we have studied about three kind of surfaces. That is the transparent, translucent and opaque. Transparent, what do we mean by the transparent surface? Transparent surface completely allows the transmission of light on its either side. Okay. Translucent provides or allows partial transmission of light to its other side. Opaque surface do not allow light to pass to its other side of its surface. Okay, it do not allow any kind of light rays to travel on its other side of the surface. Opaque. Okay, it restricts the light pathways, or we can say it acts as a barrier to the light pathway. Okay, so this is white and opaque in nature. This is white and opaque in nature. White and opaque. Next, this sclerotic layer in its anterior region. What do we mean by anterior? That is the front end part. Okay. This sclerotic layer. This sclerotic layer. From this side also, the sclerotic layer on its anterior side, or we can say the front end part of the eye, the sclerotic layer becomes transparent. See, in the posterior region, in the posterior mean in the back side of the eye portion, the sclerotic layer was opaque. When it extends further in the front end, it becomes transparent thin membrane. Transparent thin membrane. Why does it become thin and transparent in the front end? Because only if it will allow the light rays to pass when it is transparent. After passing this layer, it strikes with the lens of our human eye and then it further travels to the retina and then the image is formed. So this transparent thin membrane is called as cornea. So we can say that sclerotic layer, when it extends further into the front end or into the anterior region of the eyeball, it becomes transparent thin membrane, which we called as cornea. Next, we come to the second layer, that is the choroid layer. What is the exclusive property of this choroid layer? Let me change the color. To get a better clarity, see, this layer, which is represented by the black color, this layer is called as choroid layer. This layer is called as choroid layer. This choroid layer has an exclusive property of having blood vessels and capillaries. This layer is composed of all the blood vessels and capillaries. So we can say that this layer is a vascular layer of a human eyeball. So it consists of blood vessels and capillaries. Okay. Next, this choroid layer further extends and gets modified into a muscle. Okay. This choroid layer extends further and gets modified into a muscle, which we called as ciliary muscle. So ciliary muscle is nothing else but an extended part, or an extended part of the choroid layer. Okay. So this structure which is holding the lens, see, this structure which is holding the lens, human lens, this structure is called as the ciliary body or muscle, anything we can say. Okay, what is its function? It alters the shape of the human lens. Okay, this alters the shape of the human lens. We can say that it adjusts the shape of the cells according to the accommodation requirements. Like if the human eye is in a dark environment, this muscle gets contracted, and we know that muscle has an exclusive property of contracting and relaxing. So since ciliary body is a muscle, it also has the ability to get contracted or relaxed according to its requirements. So according to the accommodation requirements, like if we are entering a dark room, okay, our lens needs to get contracted according to its accommodation requirements. What does this ciliary body, it contracts itself, and hence the lens gets contracted. So ciliary body's function is, the prime function of ciliary body is to alter the shape of the human lens according to the accommodation requirements. Okay. Another thing, this ciliary body, from the ciliary body, another structure gets emerged out. This we called as iris. What is this iris? This is the colored portion of our eye. We see someone is having a blue eye, or someone is having a brown eye. This color of the eye is reflected just because of this structure, which we called as the iris. So iris is the colored part of the human eye. So let's write it down. Iris is the colored part of the human eye. Another most important thing, this is the lens from which the light rays gets refracted and gets striked on this retina's surface, and then the image is formed through the assistance of our brain too. So this lens in physics, you might have read about two kinds of lens, that is the convex lens and the concave lens. This human eye lens, our human eye, possesses a convex lens. Okay, a convex lens, which is bulged on its either side of, on both the surfaces, the both the surfaces of the human lens is bulged out. This is the lens. Next, another important thing, what is pupil? See, this exposed part of the lens. See, the exposed, this exposed part of the lens, which is not covered by iris on its either sides. Okay, this exposed part of the lens, which is not covered by the iris, this exposed small part is called as pupil. This small exposed part is only called as pupil. This is called as pupil. So can we say pupil is that exposed part of the lens which is not covered by iris? Okay. This is the small exposed part of the lens which is not covered by the iris. Okay. Next, this is the pupil. Okay, let me demonstrate in this way. Let's consider this is the human lens. Okay, let's consider this is the human lens. Iris envelops the lens in this way, like this way. And this middle part, which is exposed, which is not covered by the iris, this small exposed part is called as the pupil. Okay. Now next. So we have completed with the second layer too. Next is the innermost layer, which we called as the retina. Okay. This orange color, this layer, which is denoted by the orange color. This layer. That is the innermost layer, that is the retina. Okay. So, retina has the capability to, or we can say retina is the visual screen. Or it is the platform where any image gets formed. Why does it happen in retina only? Retina has two kinds of photoreceptor cells. Okay, two kinds of photoreceptor cells. What do we mean by photoreceptor cells? Photo means light, and receptor means they receive the light and change into chemical energy. They receive the light energy and then change into chemical energy, and then the image gets formed. So it contains two kinds of photoreceptor cells. It consists of two kinds of photoreceptor cells. That is the rods and the cones. Rods and cones. Another important thing, this rod and cones has a pigment, okay, which assist them to demonstrate their functions. So rods has a pigment called as rhodopsin. Okay, this has a pigment called as rhodopsin. Cones have a pigment which is called as a iodopsin. Okay, what is the function of the pigment? What is the basic function of a pigment is, pigment imparts light. Okay, what does it do? It absorbs and imparts light. So rhodopsin the rods, what does they assist in? When we go to a dark environment or a dark room, these rods gets activated, and these rods are get activated with the help of rhodopsin itself. Okay, so these are the pigments for scotopic vision. Scotopic, what is the meaning of scotopic? That is night light, or for the dim light. So during whenever we go to a dark place or a dark environment, these rods get activated because of the assistance of rhodopsin. This rhodopsin is the pigment which mediates us to see in a dark or dim environment. Okay, again, cones. Cones has the pigment iodopsin. It assists us to see in the light environment. Okay, the colors we perceive, anything like the blue, red, green, or any kind of color around us, what we perceive is because of this cones. And cones have a pigment called as iodopsin, which assists us to see in a lighted environment. Okay, next. Human eye is divided into two chambers. Okay, what is the meaning of chamber? Chamber is any small spaced room. Okay, any small spaced room, it is called as chamber. So this eye, this human eye is divided into two chambers. That is, first, this. The chamber or the space between the cornea and the lens, the space is called as the aqueous chamber. Okay. The space between cornea and lens. This space or this chamber is called as the aqueous chamber. Next. The space between the lens and the retina. This is the retina. The space between the lens and the retina, the space or this chamber is called as the vitreous chamber. It's called as vitreous chamber. Another thing, these both the chambers are filled with the fluid. This aqueous chamber is filled with an aqueous fluid. Okay, it is more water-like, and this vitreous chamber is filled with a fluid which is like more like jelly-like. Okay, so this chamber is filled with a fluid called as the aqueous humor. Okay, this vitreous chamber is filled with a jelly-like fluid which we called as vitreous humor. Okay, so it is filled with water-like fluid called as, let me write it from upper end, it is filled with a water like fluid called as aqueous humor. This vitreous chamber, it is filled with a jelly-like fluid called as vitreous fluid. Okay, so one thing we must remember is this aqueous humor is water-like and this vitreous humor is jelly like. Okay, I hope you have got a good clarity regarding the anatomy of a human eye. Next we will see in this diagram, we will connect the terms with this diagram. So this colored part, what we have studied is the iris. This colored part is the iris. Next, this black part, which is represented by the black color, this is the exposed part of the lens, which is not covered by the iris. This part was called as pupil. Okay, this is the pupil. This white layer this white layer with the sclerotic layer, and it is becoming transparent over the iris and the front end of the eye. Okay, then these are the eyelashes and the eyelids and everything. Now another thing, let's again revise on this diagram. No. See, so this white layer is the sclerotic layer. This sclerotic layer gets transparent in the front end or in the anterior side. So this is the cornea. Again, this layer, which is represented by the red color, this is the vascular layer, which contains all the blood vessels and the capillaries. This layer, this middle layer, is called as the choroid layer. Again, this muscle, which alters the shape of the lens, it is the ciliary muscle. This is the ciliary muscle. This is the human lens, which is convex in nature. This is the exposed part of the lens. This is pupil. This is the iris. This is the colored part of the eye. This is iris. Okay. Next, this inner layer is called as retina. It has the photoreceptor cells, which we called as rods and cones, okay, which mediates us to see in the dim environment and as well in the lighted environment. One another thing which we have left in the previous diagram is this retina, the lateral surface, what do we mean by lateral? The sidewise. The lateral surface of the retina here, it has a pit. What do we call pit? In Hindi, we called it as a gadha. Okay. This retina has a pit, which we called as macula lutea. Okay. This is very important for ICSE students. The lateral surface of the retina has a pit. Okay. This, or we can say, is in the form of a concave surface. Okay. This we called as macula lutea. Macula lutea is the region of high vision. Why do we call macula lutea as the region of high vision? Is because this macula lutea has high density of cones and rods. Okay, this macula lutea has high density of cones and rods or photoreceptor cells, we can say. This macula lutea has high density of cones. So whatever rays are coming, If it is falling in this region, we get the high, the best visual effects of anything. Okay, the best visual effect of anything. So even when we are reading a book, we try to adjust in such a way that all the rays gets accommodated or adjusted in such a way that the light rays which are reflecting from the book, it gets reflected in the macula lutea region. Why? Because it has a high density of cones, and all the cones get activated on rays falling on that region. Okay, so macula lutea, we can say high dense region for cones. Another important thing, this region where all the blood nerves and the blood vessels leave the eye, this region is called as the blind spot. Why do we call it as a blind spot? Because this region contains, it has no rods and cones, on its surface. Okay, it contains no rods and cones, so here no visual effect can be found. Okay, nothing can be no image can be formed here, we can say that way. So this is the blind spot, this is the blind spot. This is the blind spot. It does not contain any kind of rods or cones. Okay. Area of no vision, we can say that way. Now we will sum up all the things in a single slide. Okay. So the outer region would be called as sclerotic layer. Okay. It is the transparent. I'm sorry. It is the white, opaque, fibrous, hard tissue. Next, this sclerotic layer on its anterior side gets modified into a thin transparent membrane. Called as cornea. Okay. Next we come to the second layer or the middle layer. This middle layer is called as the choroid layer. This middle layer is called as the choroid layer. This choroid layer has the exclusiveness of having blood vessels and capillaries. Okay, so it has, or it consists, blood vessels and capillaries. Okay. Next, this choroid layer gets modified as, or we can say this choroid layer extends further to get modified into a muscular structure called as ciliary muscle or body, which alters, if it changes the shape of the human lens. Okay. Alters or change the shape of the human lens. This needs to be noted down. Again, one another thing, the last layer, the innermost layer, that is the retina. Okay. This consists of two kinds of photoreceptor cells. First,
This is rods. The second, cones. Okay. Rods have a has a pigment for assisting in the scotopic environment. This we called as rhodopsin. Mediate us to see in a dim environment. Cones, iodopsin. Okay, cones have has the pigment called as iodopsin. It assist us to see in a lighted environment. Okay, so this was the conclusion of the chapter or the topic, we can say. So with this we come to the end of the lecture. I would really recommend 10th ICSE students to refer to this video, because you have a chapter in your curriculum named as sense organs. After watching this video, you will be getting a detailed clarification regarding human eye. Also, 10 CBSE students, you can refer to this video, because you have a chapter named Human Eye and the Colorful World, which is under your physics portion. There, this video will help you in assisting you with basic terms and terminologies regarding human eye. So, if you like this video, do like, share and subscribe. And stay tuned with Mitha Guru. Thank you.